understand the students and help them out, if they find any different behavior, they can take the parents in confidence and they can speak. Because ज़्यादातर 6-7 घंटे बच्चा teacher के साथ रहता है, and especially when the parents are working, teacher is the important link when they can connect the parent and the child. कि कुछ क्यों problem है? The teacher cannot make out that something big or whatever the child is addicted to, but certainly what behavioral issues की वजह से पता चल जाए that something is wrong. So that's how a teacher can help certainly.
I would like to ask all of you, you might, like as at least that media is hyping everything today, you all might be aware of the term called blue whale, right?
What is that?
Blue whale?
Yeah.
Yeah, you all are aware. Lot of us, like 80% of us think blue whale is an app which you can download and you can play it and it's very scary, so I should just keep a watch on my child that he or she should not download blue app, right? Blue whale app. Is it right? Yeah? Anybody else who knows what is blue whale? Okay, so media has made blue whale name quite popular in every household. But to understand blue whale, so I am adding on to this because Riti said very rightly the social media society more than media, because it has entered your bedrooms, to your study room, to your, you know, every room you all are. Social media somewhere has impacted very highly these kind of jargons which has become famous. Now blue whale is not an app. You go to any app store or Android or MI or iOS, you'll never find an app called blue whale or even a hidden name for blue whale app. Blue whale is just a psychology. Blue whale is somewhere social media, as she rightly said, they're trying to, that's a game which is precisely made with only a certain number of class. Okay, but who, how they approach your kid. So the the kid was died in Bombay. Her mother is a part of the room, my boss, and we have interacted with her. And in the last panel, I was there for a blue whale panel discussion precisely. It was called as how to be a parent in blue whale time, you know. So precisely, if you understand, blue whale is a psychology wherein they try to capture people who are weak, you know, kids who are weaker, kids who are isolated, kids who are searching for some solace, especially on social media. Somewhere the master who's guiding you these tasks is finding you on the social media only, and through via network of your peer, you discover this task and you try doing it. So it's a game, but it's not an app. So nowhere you can go and Google about blue whale and not find anything. You'll not find a link also hidden somewhere in US, Russia or India. But still the cases are going on because the way your kid is using social media, that is impacting these, I would say, these masters to find your kid. Is he vulnerable to emotions? Is he really searching for? There are lot of blue whale links. If you go there, if you read the comments line, there'll be a lot of kids writing there, I want the link to download blue whale app. Watch out for these kids. They are the ones who have been writing there openly that, guys, I want to experience it once. Now that's the topic all about curiosity to relationships. They are curious to know, are it hum nahi suicide karenge, but I want to just know what is there in. They are quite strong.
About changes in their academics, maybe a decline in their interest in studies, performance reduces, right? Food habits, sleeping habits might change, like we mentioned, late in the night they are up. The dressing style might change. So pick up these certain small hints that the child might be low on self-esteem and therefore vulnerable to any form of addiction, like including the blue whale incidents. These are the signs that the children might give out even prior to being addicted to any of these.
So to what Dr. Anjali said, main aur cheez kehna chahungi, ye jo blue whale bol rahe hain, what Neha rightly mentioned, it is very prominent in schools in Bombay, which is called the Dare Game. The Dare Game. So 6th and 7th standard children or 8th standard children ko bola jata hai ki aap ladki ko bola jata hai nail polish laga ke karo, and every hour aapko pic bhejni hai group mein, insta pe dalna hai. Okay, they are asked to wear pant ka ek flap full rakhna hai, ek aadha rakhna hai, and you are supposed to move out, you are supposed to apply lipstick, ek eyebrow nikalni hai, aadhi nikalni hai. So this is what the Dare Games are happening, and it is very, very prominent. So you need to see the changes that are happening in your child. Dressing, as doctor mentioned rightly, dressing, food habits. Achanak se friends ke paas nahi jana hai, achanak se dinner pe nahi jana hai. So these are some of the issues which you can immediately make up, because you know your child ki ye sab har roz ka uska hai. Saturday parties chal rahi hai, achanak se party mein nahi jana hai. बात नहीं करनी है, ये बिहेवियरल इश्यूज होना शुरू हो जाते हैं, छोटी छोटी बात पे रिएक्ट करना, ये सब छोटी चीज है जो आपको पता चल जाती है कि कुछ तो है.
Because I've been a corporate trainer always, there's a very important functional training we do with corporate, which is taught us how to learn to say a no. You know, so professionally also, and we are talking about kids, but we all sitting in this hall doesn't really know how to say a no. You know, it's easier said than done, but we have to teach our kids that whenever and wherever you feel, because somewhere else, Aditi is also mentioning the kids, the teenagers know that smoking is not good. Or I'm taking alcohol or not, or this is not something what the parents would like. There, at times, they know what to do, but they do it under peer pressure because they've been forced to do it. Somewhere, they should understand how to say no, and that you have to teach them. Like, a lot of mothers in our group complain, yaar, why Jai Mani is like that? My mother-in-law forces me to do X, Y, Z. You have never learned to keep your foot down. It's a very lighter topic, but very deeper and tricky. Somewhere, you have to learn to say no. And if you have learned to say no, you can always teach your kid also how to do it. Like today, if you see the child abuse cases which are happening, and we have been talking about these schools, you know, somewhere the child has learned to be scared, you know, of that situation rather than knowing how to say no. You know, the first time the kid has a freedom of saying no at times. So if you teach them the right touch, wrong touch, the child will understand when to say no.